kick your shoes out for me. And cuff up your pants if you can't see your socks. So we need to talk about how to get the feet organized. We'll go about 20 more minutes and we'll take a break. Okay. When we talk about running effectively, feet are going forward down the track, period. If I'm a race car and doing this, this is a real problem because your body actually isn't designed to work this way at all. So feet forward, just underneath your lungs. I want you to squeeze your butt and flex your quads as hard as you can and pretend like you're going to spin your feet out. So they're on dinner plates and you're going to try to spread them out. Big toe has to stay on the ground. And you'll notice that I'm creating a ton of torque. Did you guys see the Chasing Khalifa video where all of a sudden he went from a flat foot to having an arch? Yeah, well, what we're really trying to do is put you in subtalar neutral, and the external rotation torque that happens to the ankle, I go from collapsed ankle to active stable ankle. All I need to do is what Mike Burgener tells me, shove my knee out. When Burgener tells me to shove my knee out, what's he really saying? External rotation. Yeah, he's sort of a genius that way, right? So feet forward, squeeze your butt, flex your quads, turn your feet out, feel that torque in the ground. That's stability at the hip. All your short hip rotators work to stabilize the pelvis on the femur. Then your hamstrings and glutes and butt and quads can do their job. Does that make sense to you guys? Stabilizers, movers, it's oversimplified, but that's a nice little image. Your femur looks like this, so it has this big mechanical advantage to rotate that thing in plane and create stability. Now turn your feet out 30 degrees. Now we turn our feet out 30 degrees with our beginners because why? They've never squatted before, and there's a lot going on, and theoretically you would unimpinge the hip. That's what we've done. So now you're at 30 degrees. Do you feel the same level of tension and torque there? Now squeeze your butt and rotate your feet out and tell me how stable you can get. How's that feel? Not good. And what ends up happening is it's difficult to stabilize. It's not impossible. But where do I find stability? With that valgus force knee. In fact, if you look at anyone turn 30 degrees, their default position is collapsed foot arch. Do you see how collapsed your feet are? Let your feet go. Just go ahead soft again like you were. You see how that foot is flat? Now make your feet straight. Yeah? And now squeeze your butt and flex your toe. And now she has an arch and her foot becomes stable. I contend that if you turn that foot out as an unconscious compromise, you're immediately going to collapse through the ankle, and we see that pronated valgus force. And that sets me up because the ankle rotates this direction. So my only plane of force is to rotate in because it's difficult to rotate out. And there, I've collapsed, and there's my ACL. Does that make sense to you guys? I've got to put my knee in a position where I can control that.